The Yellowstone Angler brings you our 2014 8-Weight Shootout. 35.
Need 60.
We're here in Boca Grande, Florida to cast 22 of the best 8-Weight rods in the world. My son Jamie and I, as well as my friends and Florida guides Bill Blanton and Jamie Allen, team up to give you our impressions of our favorite rods and what we like about them.
Two or three shots and lay it down and immediately pick the next one up and line all the way out, bang, throw it in there a couple times, throw maybe even one cast or two casts, pick the next one up, bang. You'll tell very quickly which is one better than the other.
Well, that's why I tell them when I get guys that want to buy rods, I said, if you can get two or three of them that you think you want to buy and really just go one to one, and you're going to find the one, for most anglers, the one that you naturally pick up and start casting well with is probably the rod you should get.
Sure. Bill's one of the greatest guys I've ever fished with firing it in there. Bill can throw these casts in under those mangroves. I've never seen anybody that can do it as good as Bill. He's just unbelievable. It's all that fish for snook in the Everglades, I think, that did that.
That's because I don't care if it gets hung up. If it gets hung up, you just go get it.
Yeah.
Break it off or something.
Yeah. You do have a knack for just chucking them in there and firing it in there and shooting the line in there low. I like those. I like, especially when it hits and skips in there 10 feet.
Now, Bill, would you say a stiffer tip rod's better for the real low mangrove shot or a softer tip?
I think it has to have a soft tip because, you know, a lot of times you're trying to throw a really tight loop, and I think to get that started, the softer tip helps.
And see how he's throwing? He's kind of throwing a real low, kind of a sidearm cast, getting in there. Look at that, Jamie. Look how low he throws that thing over the water. I mean, it's going in there like 2 feet above the water and turning over. And more importantly, it turns over and fires way back into these little holes back in the underneath the mangrove branches.
What rod you got there?
NRX, 9 foot for an 8 NRX. At 60 feet, it's just deadly. I mean, I can throw 60 feet with this rod with just a flick of the wrist like that, bang.
Here I'm casting right at 60 feet.
Okay, we've got the NRX, which is really good out long. At 85 feet, it'll just drill them in there. Forms nice tight loops. Thing I like about it is when you can lean on it and just give it a little crack with your wrist. And it's just got explosive power and just takes off. So you can get a pretty nice tight loop going and just use a little bit of wrist, pop it in there and bang, like that banged right on the plate at 80 feet.
I get one, you get a pickup and a go, that's it.
Okay, right from here?
A quick shot, 80 to 100 feet.
100 footer getting away. Oh, that looked like it went.
Pick it up and fire it.
See, that's strange. I think you're just used to that NRX material, the rod, because I thought the Party had more power.
I love this NRX. I mean, it's just fucking, when I lean on this thing, it just fucking fires.
Going to tangle.
Nice. Bill's casting the Sage Method 7-weight with an 8-weight line. And on that is a FWX reel, so it's a nice, lightweight, really pleasant rod to cast.
That one's gonna go.
That was the best one of the whole bunch.
And Jamie's sending them long with the Hardy Pro Access over the 100-foot line. Nice.
I'm talking about the Scott S4S. I'm saying almost as good as the NRX at mid distances.
Here we're watching Bill Blanton put it dead center on the plate at 60 feet.
Oh! Play the rod down, walk away.
They're going to have to be pretty good to the Hardy on this one.
It's just a little too tip heavy for me.
for the BBK is just so spunky and light in the tip, and I don't know, it just feels like you can cast with it all day long.
Jamie on why he liked the BBK over the Mangrove.
Great power, good accuracy, it's still delicate. Very nice.
We've got one category, Bill, for like the perfect eight, you know? So here's the rod that comes closest to being the perfect eight weight, you know? And the rod that wins is gonna win that category. Almost, yeah, I mean, it's almost sure to win that category.
What you got there, Bill?
Eight weight method by Sage.
Well, what do you think, Bill?
Well, it's got plenty of power.
It's got power, doesn't it?
Yeah, and I'm surprised that as stiff as it feels when you wiggle it, it's still really responsive up close.
Uh-huh.
Like at 35 feet, I didn't have any trouble at all casting off the tip and hitting the plate. Now I'm trying to.
I just don't get the feel though with this rod that I do with some of the other good rods in close.
No, I agree with that.
It does not have the feel in your hand. You know,
right.
It'll do it, but but it's not as accurate, I don't think, as either the NRX or the.
The Helios. Yet, so.
Helios too.
You know, tell you that.
The Helios too is really sweet. It 20, 35 feet, it is nice.
Yeah.
But it out long, it just kind of gives it up.
In a way, this one kind of reminds me of the loop rod in that it makes the cast, but you don't have the feel.
Now the loop, I was having a tough time getting the loop to hold. The loop rod, the whole tight loop's out long. It just didn't want to form a real tight loop like an NRX would, you know?
Uh-huh.
And trying to throw really long with the loop was, forget it.
Yeah.
It'd do it, but, you know, not consistently. The NRX will just pound them out there 110, 115 feet every time if you want to throw it that far.
Anybody liking the St. Croix?
Oh, the St. Croix is a nice rod, I think.
Yeah, well, I expected it to be really good up close, but I was surprised that it's so good at distance too.
It's just the St. Croix Legend Elite, the saltwater version, has always been one of our best performing eight weight rods for good reason. It just is a sweet rod. They got the flex just right. It's got a nice soft tip. It's got, I think, the softest tip of any of the rods we cast.
Yeah.
And it is sweet. It's nice. Yet it's got good butt power, so it'll throw good out long too. And for that kind of money, $440 or $450, it's pretty hard. It's a heck of a bargain, I think.
Yeah.
You know, it's just a sweet casting rod. I mean, that's the thing about the St. Croix. I mean, it does everything well, you know. Some of these rods do some things well, but not other things well, you know.
Yeah.
Personally, I think the Sage rods, the methods are great rods, but the tips are too stiff.
Yeah.
If we could just get them with a softer tip, it'd be good. So I fished for a month, Bill, down in Cuba in November. And I took a 7-weight method with me, okay? And using an 8-weight line, it's too stiff for a 7, but
yeah.
An 8-weight line on the 7-weight method was really nice, you know?
Yeah, I cast that was a nice.
That's a sweet cup. So if a guy wants an 8-weight bonefish rod, I mean, the 7-weight method is maybe better than this 8. This 8 almost is a 9-weight line.
Yeah, I think that,
you know?
I think especially for an inexperienced caster,
yeah.
That you would want a 9-weight line on this.
Yeah, for a guy that's a good caster, oh, look at that, dead center in the plate there on 60 feet. For a good caster, you can get by with a lot of stuff, but for a beginner that needs to have some feel, especially in the close to mid-range,
yeah.
Mid-ranges, then I think that a rod with a softer tip is far, far better.
Yeah.
Hey, Bill.
Mm-hmm.
We're just taking notes. Why are we wearing the buff?
Because of the sunshine on the back of my neck.
Good Lord. I mean, I know that all these young guys want to be looking cool wearing a buff out fly fishing, but we're just here casting, taking notes, for Christ's sake.
The sun is still shining and we're still in Florida.
You know, Jamie, I've pretty much decided that the two Sage method rods, the best 8-weight bonefish rod is not the 8 at all, it's the 7-weight method. The 7-weight method with an 8-weight bonefish taper is a beautiful match. It's just feels really good. Now, is it as good as an NRX? No, it's not. It doesn't have the power at long range. It's not quite as good. And close is lovely, though, and it feels so light. It's so nice. If you took that, you take that method, that 7-weight method, and put a very light reel on it, like a Nautilus FWX, an 8 FWX, you would have the most incredible lightweight bonefish outfit going. And it's got plenty of power. I mean, it'll throw 100 feet, no problem. but it just won't do it with the authority that the NRX will.
So hands down, what's the best bonefish rod?
The NRX. For me, the Lumis NRX.
Still.
It does everything well. Yeah, I mean, it's still better than anything. It won 2 years ago. It's going to win again this year, I think. I know we haven't done all the calculations yet, but in terms of the performance, it just is so solid. You know, it's not quite as good as the very best rods at 35 feet. The Orvis Helios is tremendous. I mean, the Orvis Helios is really, this guy, that would be the number one winner at 35 feet. But at 60 and 85 feet, it just didn't have the guts like the NRX. You know, the NRX was very, very good at 35 feet, almost as good as the very best. But then at 60 feet and 85 feet, it was just a solid 20. And 100 feet? The first two casts I took with it just ripped it out there at like 110 feet. So, I mean, it's got tons of power when you need it. The thing I like about the NRX is it's got all this reserve explosive power. So if you just punch the power in, bang, it'll just take off. It's amazing. It's just amazing.
You haven't tried the Hardy yet.
Yeah, I have. Yeah, the Hardy is the Hardy one-piece eight-weight is a very, very nice rod. But the four-piece is a heavy clunker, and I don't like it. You know, it's just heavy. The tip is too stiff. I mean, it's totally different than the one-piece eight-weight. The one-piece eight-weight, it's got a nice soft tip. It's very light. It's a tremendous rod. Now, why they couldn't apply that technology and that design to the four-piece, I have no idea. But they didn't, and they just totally missed the boat on that deal.
Hardy's not going to like you saying that.
Hey, Jim Murphy, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, buddy. I'm sorry. The one piece is fantastic, but the eight-weight four-piece sucks.